All right, everyone, we are back with season 52 with new tactics, Provocateur and Secutor. Today I'm taking in Onslaught, Mantis, and Mr. Negative. I've got Path 7 in Section 1, no Section 2 fight, and then a shared fight on one of the fight islands. So, new season, new tactic, everyone's learning stuff. I only have one Provocateur fight, and Mr. Negative is taking it as the Secutor fighter. Anyways, starting off, Onslaught versus Chi. First fight of Path 7. Here the game plan is to avoid parrying so that we don't cause a cleanse, so we don't cause a damage reflect. We are going to block bait heavies and retaliate and bait special ones all the way until we're to special 3. And then we'll bait our final special 1 so that she's low power, throw the special 3, come out of the special 3 and immediately dash into heavy to pause our neuro shocks. And she'll have a passive stun, so it'll be the long pause timer. Wait out the reflect, since the special 3 will trigger that through the node. And then hopefully, if needed, continue block baiting heavies, retaliate with heavies as we build to special 2, and then drop the special 2, and she will go out from the degen. Won't even have to worry about the damage reflect at that point. So, a couple benefits here, rank 3 versus rank 3. Other benefit is that Onslaught is bleed resistant, let's say, since he doesn't take damage from it and he'll only heal from it. So the only downside to the bleed is inequity. Either that or a bleed immune here, and two champions that, or any champion that doesn't really have debuffs on basic attacks. If they have it on special attacks, you can easily avoid those, like I have with White Magneto. It's a pretty simple fight. Trying to think if there's anything else special here. Nothing really to talk about besides everything that I told you about at the beginning. Here's the special 3. Here comes the pause. Throws that special 1. We're gonna go in, hit her, and bait a heavy, or we're just gonna bait a heavy actually, since it's still paused. And she was pretty much done, so I was going to relic into a heavy, and we were perfectly fine. So, super easy fight, that's what I was gonna say. So I had Resonate off, just as a habit. I'm gonna have Resonate on for the most of the season, however that first fight, we needed it off. Here we turn it back on for this Mr. Negative fight, since we need it for Secutor. It's going to help us build that tactic so that we can get that heal block up if your champion doesn't naturally have debuffs through their combos and Mr. Negative does not. I'd have to constantly evade counter. We don't have Photon. So my game plan here is PS1, parry, throw up 2 attacks, back up, parry again. We're going to get him just below a bar of power as we get to 8 light charges. Once we're there, we're going to evade counter off of a heavy in case unfazed triggers, and it doesn't. And now I'm going to constantly parry until we get 8 more charges without giving him any power. Evade counter here. If he unfazes, great. We're just going to wait out that unstoppable and then go in with a special 2. That's why I don't throw the special 2 immediately. Here we have to be mindful, even though he's ticking down. We need to be smart about building our light charges again and not giving him too many charges in case the heal block falls or in case he doesn't KO. But you saw there, the degen did its job. So, 2 evade counters, no unfazed. If it had triggered on both, we would have been safe with the first, but not the second. So we would have survived that fight, most likely. Moving on to my last fight, everybody had one fight, is this Photon here with Mantis. I contemplated taking Resonate back off, but I didn't feel like spending the units for it. And Mantis bodies this assignment, so just kind of went with it. Game plan here, get a heavy out to start so that I can place in Intimidate. Once we get the Intimidate placed, I'm gonna go ahead and build Mixed Emotions off the block. There I was attacking a little bit too fast, so Tranquility didn't prevent debuffs. So we have a little bit of some of the debuffs there. Intimidate down, special 1 out. Now I'm going to attack slowly so that we can avoid some of these debuffs as we push her, or push ourselves to special 2, baiting out some special 1s on the way. At the moment, we're really just controlling the prowess buildup so that if we do take a hit from special 1, we don't die from it. However, we did invulnerability boost, so we can at least take one special 1. And here we're in a good spot, so I charge heavy, go to 10 Furies, let the first two hits go, throw the special two. We've done this before, and it's game over. So that was the end of my war. Simple, sweet. Got my feet wet for the start of the season. So that puts me at 3-0 for the first war. And we actually are going to end up winning this war 1-0. Deaths are kind of all over the place throughout the game for war. PYCB died about 17 times, so it gave us some wiggle room to kind of get our feet wet with the tactics, since no one likes placing bosses during the offseason. So, good first war, good warm-up. Looking forward to the rest of the season and learning the tactic and the ins and outs and bans and whatnot. So, hope you guys enjoy the video and the return of Mr. Negative. Give it a like, hit subscribe, and I will catch you guys at the next war.